in New Jersey. Now Commodore flips it to the net. Off the skate of Letang, and it trickles to the near wall. We got a fight here.
Here we go.
Eric Cole and Brooks Orpik.
Here it is.
Interesting.
Been waiting for this one. Been waiting for a couple of years for this one, Staggy. After the big hit, Brooks Orpik broke the vertebrae in the neck of Erik Cole. And here's a little bit of a battle.
Orpik gets his jersey off.
It may not be tied down, Staggy. It must not be tied down. This is going to be a problem for Erik Cole.
He'll be out.
Yep.
The rest of the game. It's a game misconduct.
Unless it was tied down to his suspenders or something, and it came all the way up and over. But Brooks is trying to lay an uppercut on Cole. I think that's something that both of these players had to get out of their system, Staggy, and it goes way back to that big hit. And Brooks Orpik laid onto the backside of Erik Cole on the wall. Cole out of Oswego, New York, went down. He missed months and months of hockey. He was able to come back for the two final games of the Stanley Cup run for the Canes. Brooks Orpik's got a little bit of blood on his chin and a little bit of scratch in the left eye of Erik Cole. Take a look at the initial hit. Cole just finished off his check down along the wall, and I guess it was a quick discussion, and that was the end of that.
And Cole just left the ice. He went down the runway, so he's gone. Brooks Orpik goes to the penalty box.
And that might have something to do with that jersey, Staggy.